हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सो नाउ वी वुड मूव अहेड इन दिस चैप्टर नंबर फर्स्ट ऑफ क्लास 11th मैथमेटिक्स दैट इज सेट्स. सो हियर आई हैव सम क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू. राइट द फॉलोइंग इन रोस्टर फॉर्म. सो दीज आर द क्वेश्चंस. ओके, सो यू हैव टू राइट देम इन द रोस्टर फॉर्म. सो हाउ डू राइट इन रोस्टर फॉर्म? ओके, बिकॉज दिस हैज बीन गिवन इन द सेट बिल्डर फॉर्म. दिस इज द सेट बिल्डर फॉर्म. ओके, नाउ यू हैव टू राइट देम इन रोस्टर फॉर्म. सो हाउ डू राइट दिस? सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, देयर इज अ सेट ए. The set A contains the element x such that x is a natural number and the x is between what 30 and 36. X is greater than and equals to 30. X is greater than and equals to 30, but it is less than 36. So what could be the elements under A? Can you write it? If you see, x is a natural number, but it is equals to 30 and greater than 30. So you would write the numbers starting from 30. Okay. So first number would be 30, then more than 30 would be 31, then 32, then 33, then 34, then 35, then 36. Can I take 36? No, x is less than 30. Are you getting this? So this is how you would write this in roster form. This is the roster form. Okay. Similarly, question number second is, the set B contains the element x such that x is an integer. So here x is an integer. And the x is between minus 4 and 6. X is greater than minus 4 and less than 6. So you have to write all the numbers which are greater than minus 4 and less than 6. So what could be the elements under the set B? If you see, the elements under set could be like greater than minus 4. So greater, what is greater than minus 4? That is minus 3. Then it could be minus 2. Then minus 1. Then you have 0. Then you have 1. Then 2. Then 3. Then 4. Then 5. But less than 6, so you would not write 6 here. So these are the elements under set B here. So this is how you would write in roster form. Similarly, you have the question number C. You have a set C that contains the element X such that X is a 2-digit number. So all the 2-digit numbers you have to write. So which digit you would write? Where the sum of the digit is 90. Only those digits you would write. If the sum is coming out to be 90, then you would write it. So the elements under set could be like, can it be 10? No, because if you see sum of the digits should be how much? It should be 90, but it is not 90 here. 1, 0, it is not 90. 1 plus 0 is 1. Can we take 11? No, if you see 1 plus 1, it is 12. Should be 90. So which number you would take now? Yes, 1, 8. 18 you can take, because if you see sum of the digits 1 plus 8, sum of the digits should be coming 9. Sorry, it is not 90. It is 9, such that the sum of digit is 9. Okay, so first element could be here what 18, then after 18 19 cannot, 20 cannot, 23 yes, 27 there can be another, that is 27. If you see the sum of the digit 2 plus 7, it is coming out to be 9. Okay, then which number? Then it could be 36 also. 36, 3 plus 6, it is 9 again. Then it could be 45. If you see sum of the digit again, 4 plus 5, it is 9. Okay, then you have after 45, what could be the number? 54, just reverse it. If 45, 4 plus 5 is 9, so 5 plus 4 is also 9, so you can write 54 also. Now if you see, if 3 plus 6 is 9, so 6 plus 3 also could be 9, so 63 also you can write. Are you getting? Yes. If 27, 2 plus 7 is equals to 9, so 7 plus 2 is also equals to 9, so you can write 72 also. If 1 plus 8 is 9, so 8 plus 1 is also 9. So 81 also you can write. So these are the elements under the set C. So these are the elements. We call them the elements of the set C. Okay. So set C contains the element 18, 27, 36, 44, sorry, 45, 54, 63, 72 and 81. Here if you see, you would get the sum of the digit every time you would get as 9. Are you getting this? So just note it down. Then you would be doing some new questions here. So similarly, you have, let's say, another question. That would be the fourth one. So write the question there. Let's say, suppose we have a set D, such that the elements under D are, the elements of the D contains the element X, such that X is an integer. X is an integer, and where this X square is less than equals to 9. Okay, so again What could be the elements under the set C? Sorry, set D. Can you tell me the elements under the set D? Set D contains the element x, and x is an integer. Remember this. Integer means positive and the negative numbers. So, and the x square should be less than equals to 9. Can be 9 and should be less than 9 also. Okay. So, what could be the numbers? What could be the elements under the set D? If you see, starting from 0, square of, if you see, let me take an element here 0. If you see square of 0, because square of the element should be equals to less than or equals to 9. Okay, so I can take 0 here. If you see square of 0, it is less than 9. I can take 1 also. If you see square of 1 is 1, so it is less than 9. I can take 2 also. Square of 2 is 4, again less than 9. Square of 3, it is equals to 9. I can take equals to 9 also. Can I take 4? No, because if you see the square of 4, it is coming out to be 16. So x square is should be less than equals to how much? 9. So you cannot take this. Now move back. After 0, then comes, let's say it is minus 1. If you see square of minus 1, it is plus 1, which is less than 9. I can take there minus 2 also. If you see square of minus 2, it is coming out to be 4. Square of minus 2 is 4, which is again less than 9. I can take here minus 3 also. Square of minus 3 again 9. I can take equals to 9 also, but I cannot take 4. So these are the elements under the set D. Are you getting this? Okay. Now write down the next question. See, there is a set D where we have the element X, such that X is a prime number which is divisible, which is a divisor of 42. Such that X is a prime number which is a divisor of 42, means which would divide 42. So you have to write the numbers which would divide 42, but all should be prime. Remember this. You have the elements x such that x is a prime number, but it should divide 42 also. So what could be the number? Can you tell me the elements under C? It cannot be 1, because 1 is not a prime number. Can it be 2? Yes, it can be 2. 2 is a prime number also, and it is dividing 42 also. Yet it can be 2. Can it be 3 also? Yes, 3 is a prime number and 3 dividing 42. Yes, 3 is dividing 42. Can it be 5? 5 is a prime number, but it is not dividing 42. It is not a divisor of 42. You cannot take 5. Now we can take 7. Yes, 7 is a prime number also, and it is dividing 42 also, so you can take 7. So now more than 7, you have another prime number, that is 11. Cannot divide this. Then you have 13, cannot divide. Then you have 17, again it cannot divide. 19, again it cannot divide. Now there are no such numbers. So only these are the three elements under the set E, and the elements are 2, 3, 5, 7. Okay, so just note it down. Now we'll be doing some new questions here. That would be the fifth one. Sorry, sixth one, whatever. I think it would be sixth one. Okay. Now we have the set F. And the set F contains the element X. Such that X is a letter in the word mathematics. Such that X is a letter in the word mathematics. So what could be the elements under the set F? If you see X, the set F contains the elements such that X is a letter. X is a letter in the word mathematics. So you have to write the letter from the word mathematics here. Okay. But if you see, you would not write the number twice or thrice. Okay. If any letter is going to repeat here, so you would write it only once. So if you see, letter A is being repeated, letter T is also being repeated. Do you have any other number also there? Letter T also, yes, and the letter A also, yes, letter M also is being repeated. So you would write all these letters only once here. So what would be the element under set F? So element under set F could be M, which is 2 times, you would write it one time. Then A, again 2 times, you would write it once only. Okay. Then you have T there, again you would write once. Okay. So rest of the element are what there? H, E, then it is I, then it is C, then it is S. So these are the elements under the set F. Okay. Means the repeated one you would write only once. Are you getting this? The repeated one you would write only once, and the rest of the letter you would have to write there. Okay. So these are the elements under the set F. Okay. Now let's write the seventh one question. Now let's say you have a set, let's say it is G, and the element under set G are such that X is a prime number, such that X is a prime number. And one more condition has been given here, where X lies between 80 and 100. It lies between 80 and 100. Means the X would not be should be greater than 80. X should be greater than 80 and it should be less than 100. So what could be the elements under set G? Can you tell me? So you have to write all the prime numbers. Remember, you have to write all the prime numbers which are greater than 80 and less than 100. So greater than 80 and less than 100, what are the prime numbers there? 81, not. 82, not. 83, yes. 84, no. 85, 86, 87, 9, not. 88, 89, yes. 89 is a prime number. Then you have 90, not. 91, 92, all these are the composite numbers. Yes, 97. So these are the elements under the set G. Okay. Now write down the next question. That would be the 8th one, I think. Okay. Now we have a set H here. And the set and H contains the element X such that X is a perfect square. X is a perfect square here, and where X is less than 50, but it should be less than 50. It should be a perfect square and it should be less than 50 also. So what could be the elements under the set H? Can you tell me? If you see the perfect square, what are the perfect square? Like here, 0 is a perfect square. If you see square of 0, it is 0. If you see the square of 1, it is 1. Square of 2, it is 4. Square of 3, it is 9. Square of 4, it is 16. Square of 5, it is 25. Then square of 6, it is 36. Square of 7, it is 49. Square of 8, it is 64. You cannot take this, because this perfect square should be less than 50. Okay. So these are the perfect square. 0 is a perfect square, 1 is also perfect square, 4 is also perfect square, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49. You cannot take 64, because 64 is a perfect square, but it is greater than 50. Now you have to take all the perfect square which are less than 50 here. So you would take 0, 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49. Okay. So the elements under the set H are, there are 0, 1, then you have 4, then you have 9, then you have 16, 25, 36, 49. So these are the elements under the set H. Are you getting this? Okay. Now move to the next one. 9th question now. Is it visible there? Okay. 9th question. So let's write down the 9th question. You have a set J. And the set J contain the element X such that X belongs to the set of real numbers. X belongs to the set of real numbers. And one more condition has been given here. And X square.
Visible there? Yeah.
And X square plus X minus 12 should be equals to 0. What could be the element on the set G? Can you answer it? The set J contains the element X such that X belongs to the real numbers. Okay. And x square plus x minus 12 should be equals to 0. So let's factorize this. If you see the factors of x square plus x minus 12, it's a quadratic equation. Okay, so let's factorize the 12 on the 12. So factors of 12, you have to write the two factors of 12 so that their sum is equals to 1 here. So what could be those factors? It is 4 and 3. So you would write it like this: x square plus 4 minus 1. Sorry, 4 minus 3. 4 3 is 12, coming out to be 12 here. And their sum or the subtraction should be coming out to be how much? 1. Yes, 4 minus 3 is coming out to be 1. So you would write it like this: outside x, minus 12 equals to 0. So x square plus 4x minus 3x minus 12 would be equals to 0. You would take x common here. Here you would take 3 common. So it would be x plus 4 again. So x plus 4 and x minus 3 equals to 0. So from here you have the two values of x. You have two values of x. So x could be what? This x could be, if this is plus 4, so x could be minus 4. And x could be 3 also. So these are the two values for x. So x could be minus 4 as well as it is 3 also. So what could be the elements under set J? So the elements under set J are, what? One is minus 4 and another one is 3. So only these two elements would be there under the set J. Are you getting this? Yeah, this is how you would do the question there. Okay. Now just try the next question. That is the last question of today. I think it's the ninth or tenth. Whatever. Okay, let me write here. Ninth one. Okay. Now we have a set K here. And the set K contains the elements. X such that x here, x belongs to the set of natural number, and again x is a multiple of 5, and x is a multiple of 5, and where this x square should be less than 400. X square is how much? It is less than 400. So x belongs to the set of natural numbers. Means 1, 2, 3, 5, all these elements you have to write. But x should be the multiple of 5. X should be the multiple of 5. Means only those numbers you would write which are divisible by 5. Okay? And square of those numbers should be less than 400. Okay? So what could be the elements under set K? If you see, first one element would be 5, because 5 is divisible of 5, 5 is a multiple of 5. Then it would be 10, 10 is also divisible of 5, 5 to the 10. And if you see the square of 10, it is 100, the square of 5, it is 25, all are less than 400. Your next element could be there, 5, 3 is 15. If you see square of 15, it is 225, which is again less than 400. You can take there 5, 4 is 20. Can you take 20? 20 is also multiple of 5. But if you see square of 20, it is coming out to be 400. But you have to take only those numbers which square of those should be less than 400. You would not take 20. So only these are the three elements under the set K here. 5, 10 and 15. Okay. So that's all for today. We'll be discussing some new questions later in the upcoming lectures. Okay. Till then, stay tuned and keep watching. Thank you. Have a good day.